What's going on, my friends? This is Dustin Stelzer with Electrician U, and today we're going to talk about a whole bunch of different materials that you should know if you're getting into the residential electrical game. All right, number one on our list is Romex. It's actually called non-metallic sheathed cable. This is the stuff that you run in the walls. Pretty much everything in a house, you're going to use Romex. Number two, staples. Number three is the nail-on box. You hammer these into a wood stud and that's what holds the box in place, and then you run wire into it and you're gonna have a receptacle or a switch. This is a one gang. This is a two gang nail-on box, three gang nail-on box, and a four gang nail-on box. Next is the pop-in box or the cut-in box. These get cut into sheetrock. This is the stuff that you would use when there's already sheetrock up. The other stuff is what you would use if it's just wood and it's a brand new building. Next is the round nail-on box. So these are for lights. Usually you're gonna have these in a ceiling somewhere, run wire into it, and then your light fixture is going to attach to this. Next up is the round pop-in box or cut-in box. This is if there's already sheetrock up and you're adding a light somewhere. Number seven is the pancake. So if you have stud or something and you have to have a light right there, you would use a pancake. Number eight is the fan cake. Basically the same thing as a pancake. It's just that it's fan rated. You can't hang a fan from this pancake. You have to have a fan cake instead. You need something that has a hard side that's threaded and reinforced that can hold a fan. Next up is the fan brace. You're gonna use something like this. It's super heavy duty, usually holds between 50 and 70 pounds. We also use these a lot for really heavy chandeliers. Next up is the bar hanger. So a bar hanger is really essentially one of these nail-on boxes just on a hanger. Next up is the duplex receptacle. It's called a duplex receptacle because there's two receptacles. You can plug two different things into this. Next is the single receptacle. So just like a duplex receptacle, it receives a cord that goes into it, but there's only one. So we usually use these for dedicated circuits. Next we have the GFI receptacle. This is a ground fault circuit interrupter. This is something that you're going to use in wet locations, like outdoors or in, you know, garages, utility rooms, kitchens, bathrooms, anywhere where you could potentially have water on the floor and people could stand in that water and get electrocuted. Next up is a single pole switch. Single pole switch is essentially just an on and off. That's all there is. It's either connecting or disconnecting a wire. Next is the three-way switch. You just need to know a three-way switch is a switch that's used when you're trying to switch the same lights from two different locations. Next up is the circuit breaker. A circuit breaker is the starting point of a branch circuit. So this is just a standard single pole breaker. We have these things called arc fault breakers. They have this fancy little white pigtail that comes off of them. There's very specific rooms and locations and loads that have to have arc fault protection. Next is what we call out in the field Carflex. This is non-metallic, liquid tight, flexible conduit. Mainly we use these outside at air conditioners. All right, so since we just talked about Carflex, the next thing we should talk about is Carflex connectors. This is what we call a Carflex 90. This is a straight Carflex connector. Next up is the AC disconnect. A AC disconnect is generally used for hooking up to air conditioning units. There has to be a means of disconnection, or what we call a disconnecting means. Same thing for furnaces. A lot of electric furnaces use AC disconnect. Next up is the bell box. So a bell box is a weatherproof enclosure that you can put a receptacle or any kind of device inside of. All right, and last on our list is the in-use cover. Say you got a bell box. This goes on this. There's a weatherproof seal all the way around so moisture and water doesn't get inside of it. And once your receptacle is installed inside, there's all these different inserts. If you're using a plug, if you're using a switch, or if you're using maybe a GFI or a decor device. That's it.